go about typing somebody?
don't know, it's kind of individualized. I don't really have much of a conclusive process.
Or do
I
you
kind of try
have,
to go with,
can you
like,
give me
did
examples
you
of
hear me try to
questions?
type Chloe?
No, I didn't hear it. Can you give me some examples of questions you might ask or what you, how you might go? Type me, type me. Pretend
Type
you,
you?
yeah, pretend you don't know me, you're typing me. I'll be honest in all my answers.
All right, okay, I don't know you. Well, that's kind of hard, damn.
Okay, I'm, my
if
name's
you
just
had the
regular
option to
Eric,
go
okay?
to
Sorry. My name's just regular Eric, and you're the typing guy, and I've come to you to get
Yeah.
typed. Okay.
All right. Well, I usually don't type people immediately because that's the bad part with me. I'm not efficient enough to where I could just bing. Okay, I'll do that. But I don't have the questions. I mean, I have to have information through experience with that.
That doesn't sound very objective.
Hunter, let me just say, it
Yes,
is
it
such a
is.
pleasure to meet you. Oh my God, I've watched all of your videos.
Right. So you want me to type you? I can do that, I
What's your
guess. I can
favorite lip
try.
balm?
I can't wait to get hear what my type is from you because that way I'll know for
Oh,
sure.
look.
I think I'm an INFJ, but I'm not sure.
An INFJ. Well, are you super sensitive about yourself?
Super sensitive? I would say no, I'm not super sensitive.
Do you feel like you have to be special all the time?
No, I do like to be special, but I don't feel like I have to be special all the time, no.
All right. Do you like to go out and meet people and if you see a person on the street, how often are you going to actually talk to them, or do you just immediately say, I don't really want to talk to people if I don't have a reason to?
No, I'm pretty friendly. I'll initiate some conversations with some random people in the world, but not all the time. I'm kind of medium about it.
Yeah. Where did you get that you were an INFJ?
Well, I just like the description of them a lot about how they have visions, because like I have a lot of ideas about things. Like, I think, for example, I would like to see there be little windmills on the side of the freeway so that cars who drive past it will make those make energy that way by creating wind and
Oh, that's
making
pretty
energy.
nice.
Yeah, so
Yeah,
that's one of my I think
you
that's one of
probably.
my NI visions maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, I was going to say you probably have a little bit of NI there. I don't see the I or I don't see much INFJ, if you will, but I see the N at least.
You think I'm an
'Cause you said you
INTJ
have to.
maybe?
No, I see more E. Like 'cause you said you go and initiate, and here's a better question. Do you get super tired by talking to people for a good amount of time? Do you need to reclude back into yourself?
No, I like talking to people.
Well, yeah, that's more of an extroverted thinking thing then. That's more of how you work then. It seems you seem
I read about
completely normal.
introverted thinking. I'm very logical. I read about introverted thinking. I'm like that. So
Yeah,
I.
logic doesn't really derive from introverted thinking so much though. It's more about the T function of the F and T.
Okay. I think I may be F because I care a lot about what people think, I want people to perceive me nicely and stuff like that.
How do you go about what's your initial feeling towards something? Do you go, is your default logic or is your default how I feel?
Can you give me an example of something?
Yeah, let's say, give me a bit. I'm trying to come up with one that's not too misleading. Let's say there's, damn it, yeah, my brain's not
You
working
wake up
today.
with a third nipple.
I wake up with a third nipple. I think I'd react to that with
Again?
first horror, and then I would try to figure out why or how this had happened. If I remember, was there anything prior that I saw growing there that
That's
looked
a
like?
teeth. That's a teeth actually then, because the feeling thing would be oh my God, how's this gonna What?
I think everybody would react like that.
Yeah, the third nipple question.
If I woke up to the third nipple, bro, misleading. I'd be freaking out. Like, what the hell is this?
Yeah, that's misleading.
I think I have cancer or something.
All right, so I'm dying to know now what type I am. So, do you have any more questions?
Yeah, so far you seem like an ENT, which is kind of... Although, I can see why you might have said were an INFJ, because it's pretty close to your subconscious. Like, the ENTX duel is more closer to the INF.
Okay, so what makes you think I'm an ENTJ? Is that what you think I am, ENTJ?
I don't know yet. I can't make that decision yet. I haven't figured out whether you're more prospecting or whether you're more judgmental.
Okay.
Well, no, you are. You are more prospecting because of how you said you wanted to deal with the problems that you have. You weren't... Here's a good question. When someone comes up to you with a question... Or someone comes up to you with a general answer, do you take it into what you already know, or do you try to find out immediately how they got to that answer?
I guess it depends on the context, but if it's an abstract thing, I'll want to hear the argumentation they used, for sure. If it's a concrete thing that's related to me trying to attain an immediate goal, such as, where do you guys keep the water? And then the lady tells me, oh, it's an aisle 4. I don't say, how do you really know it's an aisle 4?
Yeah, you're like, well, this lady might know what she's talking about.
I mean, I just assume that if she didn't know, she'd tell me she didn't know. And if she does tell me something, then she's not going to lie about that. There's no reason to.
Yeah, well, you just said, the first thing you said kind of goes along with ENTPs, because you immediately said, well, I'll try to find out how she got to that. That's like halfway the whole thing on the thought process. Well, I mean, how can I put that into my own personal...
Well, I'm saying if somebody's going to come up to me and state some sort of conclusion, obviously I can't evaluate the conclusion unless I know the substantiation they're using for it.
And yeah, so you're more logical. That's the logic right there.
Right, but it makes me feel very strongly when someone... is persistent in their wrongness. I feel things like anger and disappointment and dismay, dismissal, and I feel like disabusing them of their distasteful disarray disregard. Of disregard for
you've got a discourse. Bunch of Dungeon and Dragon type.
My question is, like, what do you guys think about the new B order?
No, stop. We're doing a thing.
I don't know what the new B order is.
Take it over the...
Have the bees been told to not pollinate flowers anymore, or what?
You should see the video that I shared. It's important.
No, we don't need to see it, Chloe. Stop with the distraction and irrelevancies. Continue, please, Hunter.
Yeah, so far you seem more like an ENTP with a few strong left hands, but... You might have to do some further research into that than I have right now, but that's my feeling right now.
But aren't ENTPs manipulative? Because I don't feel like I'm very manipulative.
They're more... Well, they don't really need to be manipulative.
I care about people's feelings.
Would you choose their feelings over the right? Like, if you know something's right in a conversation, are you willing to choose that over hurting their feelings?
Well, I mean, if their feelings are wrong, then they need to change their feelings, obviously, because they're not adequately substantiated. But that's how I feel about it, and how I think about it.
Yeah, well, feeling and thinking is more of thought processes more than emotion.
I have a lot of emotion in my heart. I have a lot of moisture. Does that make me an FI user?
A lot of...
Doesn't that make me FI?
No, the people who are T don't really, the people who are T don't not, they have feeling, like, they're not stone cold.
Like, but I have like three or four, I've got like three or four feelings. At least, maybe even five.
The question is, do you default to that, or do you default to your feeling? Like, what the fuck? Did you just roast a fly or something?
I'm trying to, but they're tricky to get out of the air. I need a bigger blowtorch.
It sounds like your default is logic, and it also sounds like you have some of the like trickster functions that an ENTP does too. I might have to look more into it. I might have to do some more research.
What's a trickster function? What is that one? Trickster function. I don't understand.
The trickster's like what you don't understand. Yeah.
What I don't understand. So you mean wrongness is my trick? Is my trickster function?
No. I mean what you don't understand is in like with me, my trickster function is SI, which means like, or I think it's either SI or SE. It's like what is in the world. Like, I'll walk into a kitchen and not know where anything is if I haven't touched it. I don't understand where things are if I haven't touched it. It just does not work for me.
Well, I know I know where things are, more or less. I'm kind of sloppy and everything, but things do have a place. Does that make me SI?
Yeah. No, yours is probably not mine. I'm an ENTJ. Yours would probably not match up entirely with mine there.
So, is mine SI? You said you don't have SI?
Yours is more FI. So yours is like...
Fucker. Sorry.
Jesus.
Sorry, I was just trying to get the fly.
Yeah, yours is introverted feeling, so it's like... You don't understand how feelings work entirely with most people's reactions to things.
Because I'm too mixed up in my own feelings? Because I just am reveling in my own feelings, is that why? Because I can't think about other people's feelings, or...
No. No. You just kind of, like, don't always understand how people get to the conclusions they have with their feelings.
Because that paper towel's too moist to ignite with the flames of emotion?
Sure.
I see. I guess I'm an INFP, then.
No, you'd be... Well, you... Wait, Eric, like, back to you. Uh-huh. Does that actually happen to people where you're talking to them and giving, like, the extroverted part, and they go back to, I'm an I. I heard everything you said, but I'm still an I.
Yeah.
And
I did that.
Yeah, they always got...
I don't know how to combat that. But, I don't know how to combat that yet, because I'm not argumentative that way. But
blah, blah, blah. That's what you hear. You'll hear...
That's how I go about my type.
Sorry. Well, that's very interesting. Thank you for sharing that with us. And for you at home, that's a little demonstration of Hunter's fine typing skills. Don't forget to eat plenty of cheese, and thanks for watching.